Hey everyone, I hope you are doing well. This is my latest update video, and today I want us to explore just again the idea of bread and butter Christianity. You see, over the last few weeks on Sundays, we've been diving into Acts chapter 2 and the passage which describes early church life, and it's kind of framed with this idea of a people who are devoted to ... and then it describes the life that they devote themselves to, people who are living under the supremacy of Scripture, people who are living in fellowship, lives woven together in fellowship, lives that never move past the centrality of the cross, and they use communion or breaking of bread together as a symbol to remember and to remind themselves that the cross is central, and then lives of prayer, and then really after that, we see how those kind of devotions spill over into how they take care of one another and how they become witnesses within their community. However, here's the thought that I'd really like you to think about today. Nothing that I've just described to you is particularly spectacular. For the last 2,000 years, churches across the globe have been practicing those things. You could even describe those things as bread and butter Christianity. The Apostle Paul spoke about bread and butter Christianity in 1 Corinthians 10:31 when he said, "So whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God." Did you catch that? The Apostle Paul is kind of pushing down a life that is lived for the glory of God into the most mundane things, the most bread and butter things that he could think about. What you eat and what you drink. The Apostle Paul is basically wanting us to understand that there's no separation between the spiritual and then the secular, or the sacred and the secular. He's wanting us to see that in every moment of life, even in the moments of life that feel the most mundane, you and I have the opportunity to live for the glory of God. The most mundane moments of your life are moments when God can get the glory through us. Now, why is this important? Over the last few weeks, over the last few months, there's been increasing talk about revivals. One of the reasons why there's been like an increase in conversations about revivals is that we are getting close to celebrating the 100th year of the Lowestoft and Great Yarmouth revival that took place. A revival is a sovereign outpouring of the Spirit of God in an unusual measure, so that men and women come to know Jesus in extraordinary numbers. It's a really wonderful thing and something to be celebrated, and we want to look back on the Lowestoft and Great Yarmouth revival and other revivals from around the UK and around the world, and look what we can learn from them. However, there's also a danger, and I just want to speak into that danger. And the danger is this, that sometimes we can look to revivals as if they are somehow the silver bullet that will solve all problems in the Christian life. If only God would come and move in revival power, then everything would be sorted out. And with that, there is the danger that in the mundane Mondays and in the slow Tuesdays, we can kind of check out in our Christian life. We can think about the revivals of the past, and we can look around the world where God is moving in power, and then we can look back into the mundane nature of our lives, and we can kind of think that we are, you know, we're not even moving forward. And yet the Apostle Paul wants to remind you and I that in the most mundane moments, in the moments that feel the least revival-like moments, we still have the opportunity to glorify God. And so, friends, I want to encourage us. Let us be people who pray for revival. Let us be people who pray and eagerly seek God that he would move in increasing, mighty, sovereign power here in Great Yarmouth and Lowestoft and all down the East Coast and spilling over into Norfolk and spilling over into Suffolk. Oh God, would you come in that way and move in mighty power? At the same time, I want to encourage you to recognize that every moment, every day, every week, every season that God has called you to live that feels to you mundane, bread and butter, boring maybe, that there's still moments to glorify God, to live for him, to shape your decisions around glorifying God, to ensure that every day that you live is pointing towards the supremacy of Christ, his glory, his honor, that you're living for him to make much of him, that you're wanting to live for his fame and you're not building a little empire for yourself. Friends, each one of us can do that every single day that we're living, whether revival fire is burning or we're living in days that feel mundane, that feel, well, just bread and butter. So can I encourage us to do both? Pray for revival and live for the glory of God in the most mundane moments of our lives. Should we do that together?